All right, and welcome back again to MBAbullshit.com. So our topic for this video is stock valuation, or how to value stocks, okay? How valuable is a stock or a share of stock? So remember, you can always go back to MBAbullshit.com to check out more cool videos on these business topics. Alright, so before this video, you should already understand future value, present value, net present value, value of a perpetuity, and value of an annuity. Alright, so if you don't understand those yet, then you may watch my other free videos on these topics above. Alright, let's get down to it. Okay, first of all, just a quick overview. A stock or a share of stock is a piece of paper which says that you own part of a company, all right, or a corporation or whatever. Now you can buy it, or you can buy this stock, or you can sell this stock to somebody else, and usually you do this in a stock exchange, which is a place where people buy and sell stocks from each other, okay, or sell to each other, buy from each other, sell to each other. Alright, now the stock value, which we are going to compute in this video, is different from the stock's market value, okay, which is the price that people actually and really pay for, or actually price at which people actually buy and sell stocks in the real stock exchange, okay? So you might wonder, why on earth are we going to compute this if it's different from the actual market value that people buy and sell stocks? And the answer to that is, we compute the stock value so that we know if the stock market value is cheap or expensive at a given time. Okay, so if, for example, today a stock is being sold in the market for $10, we can first compute the stock value so that we know if $10 is too expensive or very cheap and a good bargain. Alright? So that's why we want to compute the stock value. Okay, so now, where does a stock's value come from? Okay, where does it come from? Well, first of all, it comes from the share of profits that it pays out to you. So if you own a share of stock and the company makes money, a company makes money and you own a part of that company, and you own a part of that company by owning a share of stock of that company, then that company will pay you a share of its profits, and this share of profits is called dividends. Alright, now the second main place where a stock's value comes from is the price that you can sell the stock in the future. Alright, so remember I said you can buy this stock and you can also sell it to somebody else if you don't want to own it anymore, or if somebody offers you a good price for it, or you can sell it in the stock market or the stock exchange if it's being sold at a good price. Alright, so that's where the stock's value comes from. Now let's say, okay, let's say a stock is now selling in the stock exchange at $24 per share, and it has a dividend of $2 per year. Okay, you plan to sell it after 3 years, okay? And in 3 years, the price of the stock is expected to go up to $25. Alright? So let's just say that the discount rate, okay? Remember net present value and present value, we have a discount rate, which is usually the bank rate, or the amount of interest you would get from the bank. But in terms of stocks, it's not necessarily a bank rate, but it's okay, so I'll just call it a discount rate, but we use it in a similar way. I will show you in a while. So the discount rate is 11%. So now, what is the value of the stock? Okay, so we use the net present value formula. Okay, the stock value is $2. Remember, you're keeping the stock for 3 years and you earn $2 every year in dividend. So the value of the stock comes from your $2 in the first year plus your $2 in the second year plus your $2 in the third year. Plus, the value of the stock also comes from the amount of money you will get in the future when you sell it. And we know it is $25. You see? And then, remember, using net present value formula, we have to discount or we have to bring back the values of these cash flows, okay, until today. So this $2 you earn 1 year later, you have to bring it back 1 year. One. And you bring it back 1 year using the discount rate. So in the basic net present value formula, we bring it back using the bank interest rate, right? But with stocks, we bring it back using what we call an expected rate or a required return. We call it a required return. If you want to know more about that, you can watch my other video on CAPM or the Capital Asset Pricing Model in another video. But for now, if you do not know that yet, you do not know the Capital Asset Pricing Model, no problem. Let's just believe me when I tell you that we will use a discount rate of 11% instead of the bank rate. Okay, and the bank rate might be lower, maybe 5% or whatever. So some professors will call this discount rate, some professors will call it expected rate, some professors will call it a required return. All right, so it doesn't matter. The point is that they will give you a certain percentage which you will use in the net present value formula so that you can bring back these values, 1, 2, this is negative 3 years, 1, 2, 3, okay, so that you can use it in the same net present value formula to find out the value of this stock today, alright? So, okay, this is the $2 every year in dividends, and this is the $25 at which you will sell the stock in the future. Okay, this is the discount rate so that you can bring back the value using the net present value formula. This is negative 1 because it happens 1 year from now, so you have to bring it back 1 year. 1. This is negative 2 because it happens 2 years from now, so to get the value today, you bring it back 2 years. 1, 2. And this is negative 3 for the same reason. 1, 2, 3. And then also on the third year, okay, you sell it for $25, you have to bring it back 3 years as well. 1, 2, 3. Alright? So, just take note that in this case, these are both negative threes. Alright? It is not negative 3 and then negative 4. Because you get the dividend of $2 per year for 3 years, and you also plan to sell it after 3 years. So you sell this at more or less the same time that you get your last dividend. Okay, so now, using the net present value formula, you get the stock value of $23.17.